Life depends on the ability of cells to store, retrieve, and translate genetic instructions. These instructions are needed to make and maintain living organisms. For a long time, it was not clear what molecules were able to copy and transmit genetic information. We now know that this information is carried by deoxyribonucleic acid, or DNA, in all living things. DNA is a discrete code physically present in almost every cell of an organism. We can think of DNA as a one-dimensional string of characters with four characters to choose from. These characters are A, C, G, and T. They stand for the first letters of the four nucleotides used to construct DNA. The full names of these nucleotides are adenine, cytosine, guanine, and thymine. Each unique three-character sequence of nucleotides, sometimes called a nucleotide triplet, corresponds to one amino acid. The sequence of amino acids is unique for each type of protein, and all proteins are built from the same set of just 20 amino acids for all living things. Protein molecules dominate the behavior of the cell, serving as structural supports, chemical catalysts, molecular motors, and so on. The so-called central dogma of molecular biology describes the flow of genetic information in a biological system. The instructions in the DNA are first transcribed into RNA, and the RNA is then translated into proteins. We can think of DNA, when read in sequences of three letters, as a dictionary of life. In this case study, we will first download a DNA strand as a text file from a public web-based repository of DNA sequences. We will then write code to translate the DNA sequence to a sequence of amino acids, where each amino acid is represented by a unique letter. We will also download the amino acid sequence to check our solution. In the process, we will also brush up on basic Python skills. To make the problem a bit more concrete, let's first think about it conceptually. The input to our program is going to be a DNA sequence that consists of a four-letter alphabet. We then read this sequence three letters at a time, translate each triplet to a single letter that stands for a specific amino acid, and then proceed the next set of three letters. We do this until we reach the end of the input sequence. Here is part of the table that we'll be using to do the translation. The actual table is longer than this. The input is shown on the left, and the output is shown on the right. In general, before you start writing any code, make sure you really understand the problem. Sometimes it's helpful to run through a simple example on a piece of paper before even thinking about the code itself. Let's consider the following input sequence. How would you translate this sequence? So first we identify the first triplet, which in this case is ATA. That corresponds to an I. We then move on to the next triplet, CAA, which corresponds to a Q, and so on. The third triplet, TGG, corresponds to W, and the final triplet, CAA, corresponds to a Q again. So a translation of this DNA sequence would be IQWQ. Just to be clear, the top line in this example corresponds to our DNA sequence, and the bottom line corresponds to our sequence of amino acids. Instead of doing this manually, we want to write a Python program that does the translation for us automatically. In this case study, we have four tasks. The first task is to manually download DNA and protein sequence data to your computer. The second task is to import the DNA data into Python. The third task is to create an algorithm that translates the DNA using the translation table we will provide. The fourth task, the final task, is to check if your DNA translation matches the protein string you have downloaded.